All right, I'm going to show folks how to use viewframe groups from styles. We've created at DJ&A between Braden and myself, trying some new things here. Viewframe groups are in tool space right here, and they populate, but they're deeper in the settings here. If we go into our Civil 3D categories of objects, they populate in viewframe group, viewframes, and they're combined by match lines in between the views. So we'll have to have the correct styles, which these are the canned ones that come with Civil 3D. We don't want necessarily, we'll have them in there for now, but this is one style we have made. And the label styles that go with them, which is here, and also the match line styles, which is here and here, two different types. We're gonna choose the non-masked one, as you see a little later. And we have match line left and match line right. So we have these styles in our drawing brought from our newest template, our DJA 2018 template. If you don't have them in whatever current drawing, you can drag and drop into your drawing from the settings, or you can go to the manage tab and import given Civil 3D styles that way. But let's assume we have them in the drawing and we're about to start making them. The first two things we need is an at least one alignment. Surface preferably, because we're gonna have to make a profile next. You could make a design profile, but this is gonna sample from the surface. So we have a surface, we have an alignment, and we have a profile view created with, in this case, a sampled existing ground profile line all the way down, which samples this alignment here. Now, we'll look at our tool space here. We'll go back to Prospector. And this is the alignment where we're going to make viewframe groups and views about, with this associated profile and profile view down below, named appropriately what it samples existing ground of this alignment. So let's start new commands. Before we do that, keep in mind we have an associated drawing file. In this case, it's a DWT template. Braden started this for us, and it has several different options. I've added the next one with a DJ&A ARC D size 24x36 at a 400 scale plan to profile view. So that means the plan and the profile view are going to be at 400 scale. That's imperative to know which one to pick, depending how your sheets, you can only do one at a time, pick one of these. So for example, we have all of our DJ&A 11x17 standard scales, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100. And I made one here, just I only have one for 24x36. So here's our standard DJ&A ARC D. Here's our standard DJ&A ARC B or 11x17. These are the ones you're gonna be using the most. Basically the same, just twice the size. It's important to have this north arrow, as we'll find out later. And these two as well, because in each plan view of our plan and profile views, we're gonna have a scale and a scale bar and the contour interval saying what it's gonna be in its native plot size, which in this case, it's 24x36. And in this case, it's 11x17. That's our natively produced plot. For this drawing, it's gonna be a little different because I'm doing a 15-mile pipeline for Northwest Energy. So I have another weird title block from Northwest Energy Montana. I just brought in just for this job. I copied the details from my plan and my profile, my little scrunch down 1/2 to 1 vertical profile. It's going to be very narrow in this direction. But this is the sheet Northwest Energy wants. So I made another sheet just for this job, saved as this template file we're going to need to produce our view frame groups. And I also included a north arrow, which you'll see the importance of this later. It's going to rotate this exactly how the profile and plan and profile view goes. So I made an extra sheet here for this special job, but these are our DJ&A default ones here. They have our title block, our blocks for our north arrow and our scale bar, et cetera. So let's leave this drawing, go back to the project at hand. This is a weird Northwest Energy drawing with a certain amount of DJ&A styles brought into it, but let's act like it's a DJ&A drawing mixed, not mixed, but it really is a little bit of both. So We're going to start with going to the Output tab. And to initially create view frame groups in the sheets, we got to start by creating the view frame groups right here. We're going to select the alignment we want right here. It's the only one, so we'll select that. The range from start to end, that's what I want. It's a pretty long alignment in this case, over 15 miles. I'm going to make a bunch of really large sheets. That's going to be about 10 to 12, but if I wanted to do, let's say 1 inch equals 50 feet sheets, it would make hundreds of sheets. So this command has a lot of implications for making you more efficient to produce planet profile sheets. That's its main goal. Let's hit next. I want to say I want to make a planet profile sheet in the view frame group sheet. And now I have to go to that template I was just talking about right here that I was just in. I got to go search for it. In this case, it's already found, but you got to go find it right here first. If there's an ellipsis button. In this case, Braden and I agree to put it right here in our DJNA template. Location, projects, Civil 3D 2018, DWT, and this, here it is. This is our clean one. Please don't overwrite this one. Use this as your starter. If you got to do any special title blocks or bigger sizes or anything slightly edited, save, copy, paste, and save this to your individual project. Use this as your starter file. It's all set up and ready to go to edit from. Anyway, in this case, mine is, I've already done that, and it's in my individual project, which is a couple stages deep here. I saved it right here. This is the one that's I did the save as, and I put my special title block in there I'm going to use. So that's very key. Don't overwrite the other template. Save it to where you need to. Open. And I picked gist. This is the next most important thing in this step. Here I have all my standard DJNA plan profile views. I'm going to pick this custom one in this case. A lot of times you're going to pick these standard DJNA ones. And in this case, I don't want to rotate them all to north. In this, I probably could do them because this is a pretty straight alignment from northwest to southeast, all in a line. But I'm going to say a long alignment, this usually does as it shows here. So this creates different gaps along the alignment. So I'm going to leave this just off for now. This says I would start the first view frame 100 feet from the beginning of alignment. I'm just going to start it right at the beginning for now. Let's go to the next area. I'm going to say create these view frame groups and it takes the alignment name and counts it up. That's fine. This should be set in my template settings since I have an old drawing. Let's just put it on a layer that makes sense. That's not zero. Let's put it on. See Anno view frame groups. This should be set in the template. Something we're still working on. Its name will cascade up from VF. This is also something that should be set in the template, but this is just in case it isn't. This should already be selected. Same with this. If it's set correctly in the styles and tool space, which it is now, but this is what you want here. There might be more of these coming later, but we have one, our view frame group style, DJNA frame border. We want our view frame label style. It's the only option here. We got these ones which wouldn't show anything, basic and standard. Make sure it's this one. Top left is fine. That's where the label is going to go in the view frame. Let's go to next. And now the match lines are going to populate. Let's put those on a layer besides zero in case your template isn't set up. It should be, but just in case, have it go to a layer you can freeze and manipulate easier. Same with these. These should all populate if they're in the template correct, but this is good for you to see how to populate these if you had to, or to change them to something different. So this match line would be masked, hidden. In our case, we want it to show. So we're going to pick this DJNA match line style. We're going to pick the left label style and the right label style. I'm going to say start at N and start. Next, one more. We're going to select our profile view style. It's going to make several profile views. In this case, we have our standard DJNA 1:1 vertical exaggeration, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 10. I made a really custom one here just for Northwest Energy, that's going to be even flatter than 1:1. It's going to be 1:1.5. So it's going to be vertical exaggeration is going to start getting thinner. And this is a preference until we figure out how to better use the bands. We're going to say no bands. Now we're going to create a few frames. There they create at 1:400 scale because it referenced this sheet. This is why it produced that. Go back to our drawing at hand. Our view frames are made. Our match lines are made. You can see our match lines and our view frame labels. They're going. They have a little gap overlay between each one of, let's check this, distance of 80 feet. For how long this profile is, that's probably good. But this can be rearranged later. So that's a good start for our sheets. Now our second more powerful part is to create our sheets. We're going to say our view frame group, which we just made, these blue things here. That's the only one possible. Let's say all of them. I'm going to say layouts per new drawing, put into a drawing elsewhere. I'm going to say I want all these layouts, my paper spaces, my layouts into this drawing. I'm going to call them whatever I want. I want that next counter on there. But in this case, to call them something specific to my drawing, Northwest Energy P&P plan and profile. Let's call it something like this. And this is key here. Make sure you pick the right block label. Lay DJNA North Large. I know I did a large one because I did a large sheet. There's a small one for 11x17. So this is the north arrow block. It'll rotate on every sheet. So pick the right block so it can do that. Hit next. It's going to make a sheet set. So over here in our sheet set manager, we're going to have a new sheet set, which is great if you have hundreds of sheets. Let's say where you want to save it right here. I want it to be in my native folder for this project. That's fine. I'll keep that for now. Actually, I'm going to have it go here, one folder deeper. It saves it there. Saves all the sheets to it. Got our profile and our band set. And let's choose some settings in the profile view wizard so you can really dive into how your profile views come out. So in this case, I know mine have a certain elevation between each one. Let's go to this last. It's probably one of the harder parts. Let's align the views plan profile at the start. That's typically where they align, standard in civil engineering, not the middle, not the end. This is usually going to keep it that. But let's go back into profile view wizard and let's take a look at some of this stuff. Station range doesn't let you even select those. So doesn't let you select everything in here. Gap between profile views here, this is huge. So I know mine, the first time I did this, they get a little squeezed in this direction. As you see, I'm gonna make a bunch of profile views. So let's make draw order by rows. Maximum in a row, let's say upper left side, like a book. And let's say maximum in a row. Let's just make these all in a row. You got to guess how many they're going to be created. So I'm just going to say 100 because I know that'll cover it. Let's do the gap. I know the gap between my columns. So here's one row, second row, first column, third column. I'm going to try to put them all in one big row. So in between each is a column. But I know mine, the first time I tried this, were a little too tight. So I'm going to triple this. I'm going to say 600. They're pretty big profile views. So you might have to run this twice to get these spaced correctly. So, and you'll see the importance of that in a minute. Let's see any other options in here. These get a little more advanced. I'm going to call these profile heights. I'm going to say mean elevation. Let's give that a try. Station range doesn't let you change that. That's the total length of each view. They're pretty long, 1 to 400 scale. Okay, I'm liking my settings here. This one's a big one to keep them spaced, a lot like section views. Hit finish. Now I'm ready to create my sheets in my profile views. Here's the big step right here. Needs to save the drawing. I'll let it do that. I hit okay. Select the profile view origin. Let's pick somewhere right about here. Let's let them create. It's making the sheets right now, 1 through 12 or so. It's automated. It made the sheets down here. You can see them populating. It's making the profile views. It just did. They come in really funky. I do not like that it made all these labels in this case, but that's something I should have checked in my options. Let's hit regen. You usually got to do this. I can delete those labels out easily later. And I like how I said create each one. See, that was 100. These would have crisscrossed each other. I made 600, so there's a gap here. That's what I did. I made them all go in one row this way. I said max 100. Well, there's only so many of them. So it made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Should correspond with the sheets. 7. So I might delete all these out since they're existing ground labels, not design. And I still have to delete out the grades. But essentially, I made my profile views. I got my master one up here, made them quickly. And here's the real power of it. After this, I made all my sheets. So it has all my sheets made here as well, 1 through 8. Let's go to the first one. It utilized this custom sheet I just grabbed from Northwest Energy, as we're going to it. And it aligned my sheet, it aligned my north arrow, and it aligned my profile view right here, all in one command, well, several commands, and it took a while to get the styles. So it's ready to go, almost done. There's a few things we might have to move because you don't know how if it's gonna go in here perfectly, but since we have a gap here between the profile views, we don't have to do much to clean this up. And it corresponds, plan profile view, we go to the next sheet, it slides right on down. Let's give it a second. There's sheet number 2. You can see there's a little gap there. We can move and adjust these. Our match lines help us out, these blue lines. Here's sheet 3, and so on. So that is view frame groups and match lines and creating automated profile views in a nutshell using some of our standards and also creating sheets as well using a template file.